or diet soda. And this science fair is called Carefree Soda. By me, Zachary Dunn. Background info. Now, as we all know, or at least most of us, soda fizzes. The fizz from soda is carbon dioxide gas. When you open a can or bottle of soda, the carbon dioxide gas will release into the air. Carbon dioxide is made from one carbon and two oxygen atoms. Pepsi and Coca-Cola contain H2CO3. H stands for hydrogen and CO stands for carbon monoxide. Canada Dry, forgot to add a comma, ginger ale, comma, contains ginger extract, carbonated water, and much more. If a can of soda was to be flat, it would not have as much carbon dioxide due to the release of carbon dioxide upon open. You will still receive carbon dioxide if you shake a can, however. Hypothesis. I would like to say that regular soda fizzes more, and diet soda fizzes less. Due to regular soda having more sugar and fat than diet soda. So I believe regular soda will fizz more. Pepsi and Diet Pepsi, Coca-Cola and Diet Coca-Cola, ginger ale, didn't have any diet ginger ale, just wanted to set something off from the Coca-Cola thing, a ruler, a rubber glove, my mom, elastic, and a container. Method. Cover top of can with rubber-like glove. Open soda through glove. Tie bottom of glove. Need it. Move those two around. It'd be tie bottom of glove. No, wait. Sorry. Forget I said anything. Tie bottom of glove. Measure glove. Record length. Repeat 10 times. Observations. Notes. Measurements may not be exact. After testing each soda, regular Pepsi had the majority of CO2. Why I had a zero? Carbon dioxide. Or fizz. So that's what we show on the next slide. Here are all the graphs. First and third one are both regular, and the second and fourth are both diet. The bottom left is Coca-Cola, this one right here is Pepsi, and the one in the top left is ginger ale. Well, you look at those for a bit. Conclusion. My hypothesis was correct, Pepsi-wise. Coca-Cola-wise. Diet came out over top. Although Coca-Cola was my first test, I didn't try my method before that first test. What's next? If I were to have unlimited money and as much time as I'd like, and more patience, I would try more different kinds of soda and maybe invent a new machine that would measure gas, length, width, and how much it weighed.